takes a couple of paces out of Emmanuel Bett, and Emmanuel Bett gets back to him. Then Gabri Selassie goes again. Just wonder if he's testing him a little bit. But it's pretty much a straight line now, all the way down to Glasgow Green in the finish, just behind where we're sitting here. The two solitary figures there battling it out. Susan Partridge. Now, is she tying up a little bit? Look at the gap there between herself and Freya Ross. It's almost a minute. But Susan Partridge definitely suffering there, Liz.
Yeah, she did go off rather fast, but she's still looking strong. She's holding it together. And it is a good run from Freya in second place on her way back from injury. So two solid performances so far. Been very lucky with the weather today as well. It's, you know, although it's raining, it's quite humid out there, so it's great conditions.
Well, Freya Ross there, her split time at 15k, she looks to me as though she's heading for a personal best. Her personal best 72 minutes and 23 seconds, as opposed to Susan Partridge, whose personal best is 70 minutes and 30 seconds. Now, Susan Partridge is very close to her best. Hers is the ninth fastest time ever by a British athlete over a half marathon. And now she's got Nick Samuels for a little bit of company. And if he's helpful, and let's hope he is, that's going to be a real advantage to Susan Partridge. She's working hard now. She's determined to keep it going. She's determined to try and run this time. She's got a newfound confidence. And that's what happens when you run well in a major international championships. She's now based in Leeds, but she's proud to represent Scotland, and she'll really be looking forward to the Commonwealth Games next year. This is an announcement. This means today, if she runs as she looks as though she's running, it's an announcement that she's going to be competitive in the marathon and the Commonwealth Games, and the people of Glasgow and the people of Scotland will be delighted to hear that.
They certainly will. And just having a look at the athletes lower down the table, Pauline Wanjiku has been in third place for a long, long time, but Steph Twell is getting closer. And that's an important step in the right direction for Steph Twell. If she can get closer, if she can get on the rostrum in third place, that will be a real boost to her confidence leading into the Commonwealth Games season.
Steph, again, too, has had a very mixed season this year. She had an awful injury and had to get pins put into her ankle, and it's took her a long time to actually get back to the athlete she was. So it's great that she's out here in the 10th and a half marathon.
Well, it's anybody's guess as to who can take this one. Gabri Selassie or Emmanuel Bett. I wouldn't want to put money on it at this stage in the race, but they certainly seem to have increased the pace just a little bit. As we go back to the Glen Lee, and that is where Susan Partridge is. And what a fine prospect in terms of distance running Susan Partridge has turned out to be. She's looking a little bit tired, but she's got some help there from Nick Samuels, and both of them going well.
Nick Samuels leading past the Riverside Museum, and here's a move by Haile Gebrselassie. Haile's trying to win this one. He's determined to try and win it, and he's opened up a gap. But let's not forget, Emmanuel Bett is a fast finisher. Haile's power at the finish has left him in the last few years, and he knew he had to try and break away. Well, this is Haile trying to break away, and he's pouring it on. He's accelerating. This is a real strong move, and the first serious move by Haile to try and win the race. Emmanuel Bett, don't forget, was last year's fastest 10,000 meter runner in the world. He looked to be full of running in the earlier stages. He ran away really quickly, and just recently I thought he was overpowering Haile. As they go along, they've got just over 6 minutes, just more than a mile to go, and they're coming into the city centre, and the people will be able to see on the big screens, on the television screens, as they pass the newspaper headquarters there. And there's Haile. Not time to read the papers today, Haile. Time to get them on and get going, and the crowds are moving now and settling down and seeing the yellow vest of the great man who's never run in Scotland before. And as I said, I don't think there's any country where he's run in where he's never won a race. Scotland's the only one, and is today the time when the great Haile Gebrselassie makes his first visit to Scotland a winning one. Liz, it's a pleasure to watch him, isn't it?
It is. I mean, even when he's running at his top speed, he just looks so comfortable. And that's, you know, that's what you look for in distance running. You've got to be economical and, you know, you can't force it. And this guy just shows the essence of what distance running is.
He was explaining yesterday, if you look at his action, you see his right arm is working, it's like a proper runner. His left arm is fairly static. And he was explaining yesterday that when he was a kid and he ran to school, he carried his books in his left arm, so his left arm became static, and he ran when he was running. He was driving with his right arm. And he says it's he's never been able to get rid of, he's trying to get rid of that action. He's trying to get rid of that action where the right arm works and the left arm just sits there passively. But he said, I've never been able to do it, but it hasn't slowed me down too much.
I don't think I've ever seen any athlete that's portraying in motion. You know, there's always something that's not quite 100%, and because as a human beings, we're not all perfect, but he is a perfect, as endurance running goes, he shows what perfection in running is, and that's due to hard training, work ethics, and a dodgy arm.
Well, the man with the dodgy arm has taken about 100 metres out of Emmanuel Bett in the last mile or so. But he is suffering. He is paying a bit of a price for it. Maybe if we could just have a look back and see what the gap is.
Move ahead then.
We get a very good idea. There we are.
Okay, they just wanted to see the gap.
Oh, it's a good 100 metres, isn't it? But Gebre Selassie has broken at just the right time as they head along the embankment. Inside the last mile, towards Glasgow Green ahead of them, under the railway station. And just in the distance there on the right-hand side, you can see Glasgow Green. There you are, the marquees are where we are, and that is where they're aiming for. It's not far to go, 1 mile to go, and Gebre Selassie at the moment is the man that everybody is hoping can win it here. Will certainly bring a boost to road running in Scotland, that's for sure. And you can't say he doesn't deserve it. Neither does Susan Partridge. She really has performed well here. It's been an individual race. It just looks full of grit and determination, as she has from the start. It looked as though she might be getting away from the man who's paced her all the way, Nick Samuels. Well, she is just ahead of him at the moment. Nick is totally on his own now on the other side of the road. And Susan Partridge looks as though she's got some of that grit and determination back again, as she had in the beginning.
She's running well now, approaching the hour point. 70 minutes, her target, her personal best of 70 minutes. She's got the conditions to do that. She hasn't got the competition, but she's had good help from Nick Samuels running alongside her. There he is, just drifted off to the far side. But Susan Partridge, well, you would say one of the most improved athletes in Britain this year. 10th place in the World Championships, a recent run close to a personal best, over 10 kilometres on the road. And there we look overhead now and we see the yellow vest of Haile Gebrselassie with a couple of minutes running ahead of him and some cheers waiting for him here at Glasgow Green. There were three of them together. Lam Dasang was a bit of a danger. He's only a few seconds outside the 61 minute pace. And remember the course record, 61 minutes and 10 seconds. Haile's come to this country. He told us all yesterday he's here to win this race. But it looks to me as though he's gonna win the race. Can he set a record? Can it be the fastest ever half marathon in Scotland? 61 minutes is the time he's heading for. 61:10 is the record, and he wore them down. He realized he had to be in a position clear of the field when he got to the last mile, and he worked for it. He injected a really quick mile there at between 11 and 12 miles. 4:39 was a quick one, and that really did the damage to Emmanuel Bett, who I thought was looking dangerous. And now Haile, as Liz McColgan was saying, if you look at his action, even after these distances, even after all these years, he's got a beautiful distance running action, almost a perfect action, and the records he's set and the times he's run have been formidable. But there he goes underneath the bridge, the yellow vest appears on the other side, and now these people are realizing they're watching the greatest distance runner of all time on his first appearance in Scotland.
A Well, he's going to hear the applause in just a moment's time. He approaches Glasgow Green through the McClellan Arch. You just about see the finish from here. 300 metres to go for the greatest. And he's just got enough energy left to put on a little bit of a show at the end. 200 metres coming up. And Haile Gebrselassie doing here what he couldn't do in South Shields. In the Great North Run, on that occasion, he was beaten by two very good athletes indeed. And this time, it's going to be so, so close to 61.10, which is the record. Can he get inside it? Surely he can. So Haile Gebrselassie, very close. And that is a course record. Gebrselassie wins 61.06, and not only has the great man done it, he's produced the fastest time ever for the half marathon distance. And there is Emmanuel Bett finishing in second place. A couple of miles back, Gebrselassie just put on a little bit of a spurt, and then a second one about half a mile later, and that pulled him away from Emmanuel Bett. But Emmanuel Bett has played his part in this race. 61.36, and those two way, way ahead of anybody else. Lam Dessem, former Moroccan, now running for Spain. He's run the majority of this race totally and utterly on his own. And that is just outside his lifetime best for Lam Dessem in third place. So we have our first three. Now, where is the first Briton?
Well, Haile Gebrselassie came to this Bank of Scotland Great Scottish Run with something to prove. He came in here thinking, I may be the only
Well, the
guy.
First three the there off to have their photographs taken, and we're waiting now for Jesus España, who is just ahead of Chris Thompson. That was back at the Riverside Museum. He's about 15 seconds ahead. Now, whether Chris has managed to make up any of that time, we're not sure. But Brendan, what about Haile Gebrselassie? He truly is the greatest. You can't say a lot more than that, can you?
That's absolutely right. He came here, he promised to try and win it. He said, I've never been here before. I'd love to win it. He's come here for the first time in his running career at the age of 40, and he's run the fastest time ever run in this race. As you look at the former European champion, Jesus España, who's coming back from serious injury to both Achilles tendons after multiple operations, and now an athlete who's got ambitions to run on the roads in the winter, and then he tells me his big ambition for next year is to try and win the 5,000 metres again at the European Championships. And his big hope is that Mo Farah will give it a miss and only run the 10,000 metres. There he is, Paul.
Well, Jesus España, well ahead of Chris Thompson. Been running... there's Chris Thompson just coming into the finish area. So Jesus España is about 150 metres ahead of him. It'll certainly be good to see this man and Mo Farah on course for a European title once more, but we think that Mo Farah will dip out of that one. But Jesus España it is, who wins the fourth place battle between himself and Chris Thompson. And Andrew Lemoncello it is, putting on a spurt. I just wonder if Chris Thompson knows where Lemoncello is, because Lemoncello is gaining with every stride. Chris Thompson just taking a little glance behind him. He's certainly confident of crossing the line in fifth place, that's for sure. He's running this like a triathlete would finish a race, isn't he?
Yeah, it's a bit strange, isn't it, to see him celebrating in fifth place. But he's enjoying it. He's used it as a training run, and he's just soaking up the atmosphere for when he does actually hit the marathon, full marathon.
It's going to be interesting to see Chris Thompson run the full marathon distance. Andrew Lemoncello, crosses the line in sixth place. Good result for him. Whether the experiment worked in terms of going to bed, what, later on this afternoon?
Yeah, to see
if it worked.
He just stayed up all night and then he said he was just going to go and have a nap and then get up and sleep today after the race. So hopefully, I don't know if it worked out for him or not, but it's not his quickest time.
I bet he's not the only one in this race today who stayed up all night, Liz. A few of you who are still out on the road.
Maybe.
Well, looking back down the course, about what? A mile and a half behind is Susan Partridge. A solitary competitor. How much strength has she got left to bring it on home? She's got a lifetime best of 70.32. She ran earlier on this season. And she was well ahead of Freya Ross a little bit earlier on, Freya Murray that was. And she seems to have regained the length of stride, the cadence, without too much of a problem. She is suffering a little bit, make no mistake about that. She's run this very hard. But at the moment, Susan Partridge well in the lead and now heading towards what we hope will be a very fast time.
It's been a great performance for her when you consider that it's only 7 weeks that she did actually do the full marathon, and most people's legs are just coming round after about 6 weeks. So to actually have been out and raced last week and then come back and do the half marathon run so well and strong today shows that things are looking really good for her for the Commonwealth Games in 2014.
Well, she's got great times ahead of her now, hasn't she? She's got a real confidence boosting season and a glorious victory for her in the Great Scottish Run. That's assured as she comes under the central station and well within sight of Glasgow Green. Still working hard though, she's going for it now. All these athletes, she knows she's got the race won, but then it's about times. They train hard, they know what times they do in training, they know what their targets are, and her target surely today is her personal best. It's going to be close though. 70.32 is her personal best. She's going to be very tight on that one, but she's got to enjoy this victory. These are good times in her athletic career. Susan Partridge spent a lot of her time training up here in Glasgow. Recently has been living in Leeds and working and training there, but here she is looking good, Liz.
Yeah, she's looking really strong and she has ran consistent from the start. You know, although she's looking like she's slowed somewhat, she's, you know, kept her form really well and is looking strong and just going for the win now. But she does train at altitude. She trains up at Boulder, Colorado, as does Freya Ross. And, you know, I think it's worked really well for her, and her and consistency in miles up there in her training has really showed today. She's a strong runner and that shows when she does do championship races.
So just one figure that we're all looking at now as we pan ahead to see where Glasgow Green is, and there it is. There is the finish area. We're just sitting away to the left-hand side of that. So back to Susan Partridge, and now all she can do is watch the clock. Long gone are the times that were set by Liz McColgan back in 92 and Paula Radcliffe in 2003. And Freya Ross there, back in second place. She's, goodness only knows how far she is behind Susan Partridge. And she certainly seems to have slowed a little bit, but her form is not suffering too much. The cadence is a little bit less, the turnover, than that of Susan Partridge, that's for sure. Freya Ross surely is going to batter her lifetime best as well. And there's Susan Partridge. Now come on. She's going to be just outside that lifetime best, I feel. But she is getting close. It could be on. It could be on. She's just got this last turn. Then the last 150 metres, 200 metres or so beyond the arch. She could do it, but it's going to be close. Well, certainly the crowd will be well aware of the fact that she's going to represent Scotland at the Commonwealth Games next year. they'll be anxious to give her as much support as possible. She's going to be outside 70 minutes. And Susan Partridge is going to get very close to her lifetime best. That will give her confidence. She will know she can go into the remaining races this season full of running. Maybe did a little bit too much earlier on. It's going to be very close indeed. 70.32 is the time she's aiming for. So no doubt about the fact, Susan Partridge is number one in Glasgow, probably in Great Britain at the moment, and it's going to be just outside. But what a great victory by Susan Partridge in this great Scottish run. And shows she's absolutely delighted. Freya Ross it is, who's coming into the park. That's got to be a huge lifetime best, Liz. And that will delight the Scottish crowd as well as the athlete herself.
Yes, two great performances today from the girls. Massive PB for Freya, and especially coming back from a really bad injury. So, you know, it's looking well for Scotland as far as Commonwealth Games go. But, you know, for Susan to run just off a personal best after 7 weeks completing the full marathon is an absolutely amazing run. It shows that there's a lot more to come from Susan.
Well, Freya Ross has got a marathon planned towards the end of this year. She hasn't quite decided on a venue yet. If she can run in this sort of shape for half the distance, well. So Freya Ross it is, who's going to come in second place behind Susan Partridge. She's got a lifetime best of 72.23. It's certainly going to be inside 72 minutes. Great second place for Freya Ross. Belongs to the Chesterley Street Club. Now Pauline Wanjiku, we haven't seen much of her since the front three broke up. Susan Partridge, Freya Ross and this athlete. But certainly the Kenyan just lost her way a little bit as they approached Bella Houston Park. That's when the front three split up. So they've largely been running on their own and she's certainly suffering as a result of it. But nevertheless, has a lifetime best of 70.28. So well outside that sort of time. But Wanjiku it is who gets third. She will be absolutely shattered at the end of this. What a good race it was from Freya Ross and of course from our winner. Pauline Wanjiku has been running all over Great Britain. There's Stephanie 12. She was gaining at one point. We thought she might catch her, but she's back in shape, isn't she?
Yeah, it's great to see Steph go out here and do the half marathon. Obviously, for the Commonwealth Games, she's been selected for the 5K. She is a track runner, but in a few years' time, I could see her moving up and being successful at the full marathon. So, you know, it's a good, solid run for her. She's just had a full track season, obviously had a couple of weeks off, and she's just coming back into her training. So that's a good, solid performance in fourth place from Steph.
It certainly is, and three Scottish women in the top four. That says a lot for Scottish distance running, doesn't it?
Yes, exciting times for us for the Commonwealth Games. Not only have we got three girls in the top four here, we've got you know, a lot of men and women that are running for Scotland now that are going to be in more finals and got opportunities to win a lot of medals at the Commonwealth Games. So, you know, it's all come right at the right time for us. And, you know, I think that when the Commonwealth Games come, a lot of the Scottish people will actually know these guys and be supporting them, and it'll be a fantastic experience.
I'm sure it will. Steph 12 gets third place. Fourth place, rather, I beg your pardon. So applause all round from the front three, Susan Partridge, Freya Ross and Pauline Wanjiku. And Steph 12 was gaining on Wanjiku at one point, about 2.5-3 miles ago, but she couldn't quite keep the pace up. Nevertheless, the winner, Susan Partridge, can walk off the course being absolutely delighted with her performance. Well, there we are, we're back towards the hydro. No Rod Stewart at this moment in time, but certainly a lot of athletes. Well, that's been quite a morning, hasn't it? From the women one of the greatest athletes there's ever been in Haile Gebrselassie, winning here for the first time in Glasgow, and a great tussle between three Scottish athletes and Pauline Wanjiku of Kenya.